Good evening and welcome. My name is Kurt Cologne, and it is an honor to pay tribute to our dear friends Todd Lloyd and Christopher Newman. As we can see by the amount of people here tonight, these two men meant so much to so many people. I can say confidently on behalf of all of us, there was a privilege to have friends like Todd and Chris. Todd Lloyd was a true pioneer in our industry. His knowledge, leadership, and charisma helped him gain success, not only in business, but in making real friends and lasting relationships. So tonight, in true Todd Lloyd fashion, we're gonna do something nice for somebody else. As many of you know, Todd was very active and a huge leader in our NACE organization, as well as the industry. Todd believed big time in the future, and specifically in the student chapter. So what we're going to do is we're going to raise money tonight, and 100% of the proceeds are going to go to the Todd Lloyd Scholarship that is going to help the next generation of leaders get involved in our industry, and we're going to give them a big financial boost. So I appreciate everybody here tonight helping out and all of those that worked hard to put the scholarship together. And I thank you for your future donations to the scholarship. So thank you all very much. And at this time, it is my honor to introduce Mr. Brennan Donovan, and he's gonna bring several members from the Top That Event family and the Chair Covers and Lennon's family up to the podium. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Brennan Donovan.
Welcome to the celebration of the life of Todd and Chris. As Executive Director of Chair Covers and Linens, I work just beneath Todd Lloyd. I just said that, didn't I? He's getting a chuckle right now. Keep it clean, people. Many of you may not know who I am. I've been the guy in the shadows for my number one hero, helping to run Todd's big, crazy circus. Both Todd and Chris would get a kick out of me being up here with you tonight, as they just know how torturous this experience would probably be for me. Even in their passing, they continue to better me by pushing my comfort zone. We would like to thank our team of heroes for holding down the fort under intense grief. Thank you for your support, your tireless work, your unending belief in our leader and President Todd Lloyd. Your commitment, your courage, your lasting memories of the passion and the drive of our fallen hero will ensure the next chapter of our legacy. Thank you to our band of heroes. Thank you. If you're a member of NACE, ISIS, or ABC, can you stand for us tonight? If you're able. Bar's not been open that long yet. To our friends in NACE, ISIS, and ABC, and the event industry at large, our family would like to thank you for allowing Todd to play in your sandbox. For allowing him a vehicle to sharpen his leadership skills and practice fierce conversations and the speed of trust. Thank you for helping mold the leader that we all love and know. Your outpouring of support is unmeasurable and has been a comfort to us all. Thank you. Todd made us all better in so many ways, didn't he? For me, his greatest gift was affording me entrepreneurial freedom, trust, honesty, and transparency that provided a foundation for growth, both personally and professionally, providing many blessings for which my family and I will forever be thankful. We lost a great orator and a debater, we did. Todd kept my debate skills in tip-top shape. He hated to lose a debate, and he hated having to admit that I was right, which was often. He was one of the best I ever knew, and I am so much better for it. You couldn't help but admire Todd's ability not to worry and stay positive, even under the greatest of pressure. Todd was bigger than life, positive, a jovial character who didn't like to worry and did very little of it, sometimes to his own fault. But the benefit of this state of mind allowed him to inspire and innovate and demand better of us, providing the confidence and leadership that would beckon us to follow. This lack of worry provided him with drive like no other I've ever known. Todd was my best friend, and like a brother, but a best friend to all. I have come to realize that I am but one amongst an army. His reach across multiple circles of influence was astounding and viral. I've spoken to so many of you, some of you meeting you for the first time, telling me how Todd felt about myself and my family, while at the same time, Todd had spoken of you in the same way. What an amazing, gracious man, and with incredible reach. Incredible reach. Todd was a giver. He was the most generous person I've ever known. He would gravitate to anybody with a need, and if he caught wind of it, he wanted all in. Always offering himself, regardless of personal sacrifice. Todd was always there at every milestone in my family's life, ensuring his place in my family's legacy, with Chris right by his side. You know, when I first heard of Chris, I was in LA, and my wife Todd and I, as well as some of our other team members, were there for special events. Todd told my wife of his potential new love in his life, and he was obsessed, crazy, nuts. He was so in love. In time, we came to know Chris, and in the beginning, well, Chris was the one I loved to hate. Chris was so much like Todd in so many ways, outspoken, transparent, inquisitive, and like Todd, he loved a great debate. I was thinking, geez, now I have two Todd Lloyds in my life to satisfy. Fantastic, just great. As with Todd, these same traits mirrored in Chris provided for a friendship that soon turned to a family bond that went well beyond any bloodline. A special memory we will always cherish in my family was a trip that Chris, my wife, my son Hayden, and I took to Chris's condo in Boyne. Todd was busy, you know, burning the midnight oil, big surprise. So we decided to go up north without him. He was gonna join up with us later. We were able to share with Chris a special drive along the East Jordan River that is one of my wife and I's favorite destinations in Michigan. It's beautiful. When Chris saw the road that traveled along the river, he was so worried about scratching Todd's Yukon and dirtying the rims. He really did like to keep those cars clean. He really did. For me, the core legacy they leave is their passion for making memories for those they loved, as well as coaching us to do the same. Make those memories. Don't miss important opportunities to do so. Todd told me this often. Many of you, like I, have been blessed with Todd and Chris's memory-making antics. Maybe some of you will share those amongst yourselves tonight. I know there's a lot of them. In honor of this legacy, I thought it would be fun to act on creating a special memory right here, right now, for somebody in this room. Who wants to help me create a special memory for somebody tonight? Are you with me? Kurt, how about some music? This is Austin, Todd's nephew. Chris, Todd, and Austin shared many, many adventures together. Austin came to me shortly after Uncle Todd and Chris's passing and wanted to do something big for them. Austin himself, just like his Uncle Todd and Uncle Chris, wanted to create something for them, just like Todd and Chris wanted and had created for so many others. Austin, I think, wanted so much to experience the nature and iconic essence of what Uncle Todd did in making dreams come true for so many, and creating special memories. Am I right?
Yeah.
Oh, thank God. Austin, we would like you to be the recipient of this special memory in honor of Uncle Todd and Uncle Chris tonight. I am honored to present to you the Todd Lloyd Christopher Newman Favorite Fan Award. Congratulations. All right, Austin. Are you ready for another icon moment?
Sure.
You ready? Let's do it.
Everybody, put your hands up in the air. Let's make some noise for Austin. Woo! Time, everybody, put your hands together for Mr. Austin.
I would like to introduce our director atop that event, Mark Ephraim.
Austin, you're the man. Rock on. Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you, everyone, for coming here tonight. All these faces is just an amazing testimonial about how loved Todd and Chris were and are. I'm going to be brief. I just want to share a couple of things with all of you. I've known Todd for about almost 15 years. I've actually known Chris longer. I met Chris a couple of years before that at another company I worked at, setting up a lot of events for the automotive industry. And I believe it was probably right at the beginning of Chris's career. I'm not sure how much we thought of each other at that time. He thought I was a big mouth that yelled a lot, and I thought he was a smart little guy that thought he knew what he was doing. Years went on, and we kept seeing each other over the years, and it was just business acquaintance, running into one another at all the different events. And then over the years, my relationship with Todd started out as a business relationship and grew into a friendship that I can't even describe how close we were. I'm going to tell two brief stories to tell you, but kind of to mirror something Brennan said, one night Todd and I were going to a NACE meeting together, and he decided that we needed to blow off the NACE meeting because he needed to tell me about this new love that he was getting involved with and the whole story. So we spent the whole night talking about it, and many, many more nights after that talking about it, and finally came to the time when I got an opportunity to meet Chris, and we saw each other, and I don't remember exactly where we were at, but I remember exactly what we both said. He looked at me and said, "You're the Mark?" And I looked at him and said, "You're the Chris?" And so it began again, and it really wasn't until the last two or three years that Chris and I got to know each other and got to develop a friendship through Todd, and got to enjoy in each other what we liked a lot. We both like really cool cars. That was one thing that we had very much in common besides Todd. And so it went on, and it was the last couple of years has really been great. We've really been able to have that honesty with one another and talk about the past and talk about the things that we liked and talk about the two of them. And it was really a great feeling to finally get to know him after all those years. As for my friend Todd, two things that I'll leave you with. I've been trying all week to come up with a way to tell everybody how close we were and how much we loved each other. And two things I'll mention. When Todd and I first talked about our businesses coming together, him buying MPE, we talked about all the things we want to do, how we're going to do it, all in like 2 weeks. And the important thing about it is that, and a lot of people criticized me and told me how crazy I was, we did it by giving each other our word and by shaking hands. And that's all there was. And people said, "Are you out of your mind?" And I said, "You don't know my friend Todd." Last summer was probably one of the greatest experiences that I've had, and probably the biggest outpouring of love that Todd has ever shown me. And he often sat across from me at my desk atop that event, and he heard me talking to my son. My son was going to be introduced and accepted to the Tennessee Bar as an attorney. And for a lot of different reasons, I might not have been able to make it down there. And my son was considering maybe just, you know, getting the paperwork and not actually going for the ceremony. And when I hung up the phone from him, Todd said, "Call him back and tell him that I'm flying you guys down there." And that was on January 11th. And so Todd took myself and my son and his girlfriend and flew us down. He was still here, hadn't moved back down to Nashville yet. Flew us down to Nashville for the ceremony. We went to the ceremony. And when they announced my son's name and presented him to the Supreme Court justices of the Tennessee Bar, I looked at Todd and Todd looked at me, and we were both crying. And he said, "I'm so proud of Matt. Mark, I can't tell you. It's like he's my son." That's my friend Todd. God bless you, Todd and Chris. I love you.
I'd like to thank our memory makers, Kurt and Kevin and Prem and the lighting guy for helping, as well as the audience tonight, put together this memory. Thank you, Mark. Great memories of Todd and Chris. Something Todd always said, it's a kind of a famous saying, is, you know, we're not here for a long time, we're here for a good time. With that said, I would like to introduce to you somebody who's no stranger to a good time. The next president of Chair Covers and Linens, Todd's dear sister, Rachel Torok.
I see Kurt brought this down to my level. I know we've been up here a long time talking about Todd and Chris, and this is a little different perspective, so I'm not the wordsmith. That's not what I was in the relationship that Todd and I had. But I hope this speaks to your heart and tells you what Todd meant to me and so many of you. What kind of person was Todd? He was a loving partner to Chris, a son to my mom and dad, a brother to Patty and myself, and an uncle to many nieces and nephews. He had 7. And he was a friend and mentor to many of you. We come from a large family, and it was one thing Todd valued most was the relationships he had with those he loved. Even recently, we were discussing something, and he told me more than business or anything else in his life, it was relationships that mattered the most to him. And I was lucky to be one of those closest to him. You may think I was the luckiest little sister in the world, but I'm here to tell you, although I do feel blessed, growing up with Todd was not always easy. My sister and Todd were 10 and 11 years older than me, and I always felt like I didn't fit in with them because I was so much younger. They were so close, Patty and Todd. Well, and I was just so young. I was overweight growing up, and I always felt pretty insecure. But Todd always told me that beauty was an inside job. And he did everything he could to give me confidence and love. I can remember him taking me to a field and having me pose for pictures and telling me that I was like a model. I felt like a queen that day. And well, that's the type of person he was. He had a knack for making you feel larger than you could imagine. I was the worst little sister you could have had. I pretty much told on him for everything that he did. And somehow he never held it against me. My family would gather at the table, and we all had our own seats, and Todd happened to sit next to me. I would raise my hand, and my dad and my sister, they never knew which one was going to get in trouble. And if it was really bad, I would ask my mom to go down the hallway so I could tell her what had happened that day. The best one I can remember was announcing at the table, "Hey, Mom, when do I get to steal the car and skip school like Todd did?" I was also able to trick him a few times, and one of those was at the dinner table as well. He always liked to steal food off of my plate. So a French fry had fallen to the floor, and our dog chewed on it. I quietly put it back on my plate and waited for him to snag it from my plate. Indeed, he did. And I looked, and I let him eat it, and then I looked up at him and said, "The dog ate that." He supported me as I grew into a young adult and even took me to college on my first day at Michigan State. At that time, he was living in Lansing, and it was then that we grew closer. He moved to Detroit before I finished school, but we continued to grow in our relationship. Todd was always reading. He was reading Think and Grow Rich and any motivational book he could get his hands on. He completed a Dale Carnegie course as a young adult. He started a business with my family in Midland called Action Bowl. When that didn't work, he went to the city and began a flower shop in Roseville. My whole family would support Todd on those crazy floral holidays and work until wee hours of the morning. Again, this is the kind of person he was. You could have just worked 20 hours with Todd, but he made it fun. And he had such enthusiasm for whatever he was doing that you wanted to help him reach his goals. Many of you know the beginnings of CCL, but for those of you that don't, Todd was not having the success he wanted with flowers and things, and he decided to add chair covers to his business. He brought a cover up to my mom and said, "Could you make these?" Well, that is where it started. We made the first 400 chair covers for my wedding in 1997. Todd gave me the wedding of my dreams, and that's what he did for so many others. He enjoyed giving others dreams, whether it was a dream wedding, a dream party, and during that process, he would touch your heart in a profound way. That's the type of man he was. I stayed on up north to finish my master's degree at Central Michigan University, and upon my completion, Todd offered me a job with him while I looked for a job in my own field. I ultimately found a job in my field, and I was so scared to tell Todd that I wanted to leave. But in true Todd fashion, he looked at me and said, "What only brings you happiness is what I want for you, and if it's not working here, then that's okay." That didn't last long, as I was calling him back in a few months, asking if I could come back. I loved working with Todd and the environment we had, even if it was pure chaos at the beginning. We had each other and we had wonderful people working with us. People would call and he would say, "Go look in that pile, go look in that pile." We didn't even have a filing cabinet when it started. Soon we were outgrowing that space, and on a handshake and a loose contract, much to what Mark spoke about, we are in the buildings that we are now. I remember when he took me there, I said, "We'll never fill this space." And he said, "Wait and see." At one time, I wasn't sure if our linen company was a small petting zoo or actually a linen company. Todd was a lover of animals. We had Lucy, a big yellow lab, that would be sitting under the tables. And after the consult, or just whenever she felt like it, she would walk right on out. It would scare some customers. We also had an African gray who was named Trixie by Todd, and a bunny running around the store. And I remember at the end of our first year in that new building, he asked me, "What should be our goal for next year?" And I said, "Double what we did this year." "Really?" he said, and I said, "Yes." I think that was one time my vision was larger than Todd's. Todd and I supported each other through so many of life changes, the big ones and the small ones. We were there for one another. He would encourage me through the rough times, and he celebrated with me during the good times. Again, this is the type of man he was. Todd always played outside the box. He liked to push the rules, and this is how we balanced each other in life and in business. I never resented being the one that most of the industry didn't know. I was behind the scenes, and in the background, doing what I did best, Todd was in the spotlight, creating relationships with our customers and doing what he did best. Often at work, people didn't know we were related. There was a time when one of our employees asked Laura, who's been with us from the beginning, "Why does Todd give so much attention to Maggie when she comes in?" She said, "That's his niece, and Rachel is his sister," and everyone got a chuckle out of that. Todd always liked to shock people with either his Polish joke, "Don't ask me to show you that one," his choice of words, his gestures, or his ability, to let wind blow whenever he felt the need. We would be sitting in our meetings with staff, and yes, you guessed it, right there, he would let it rip. We would usually pause, look at him, and he would just be laughing his wonderful, infectious laugh. He once told me, "Shock factor, it makes people remember you." And as you can see by the outpouring of love for him, he was right. Todd always had big dreams. Before one thing was completed, he wanted to do the next. It is how he lived, moving at the speed of light and trusting those around him with the speed of trust to follow through on those things that he had started. He was the visionary, and he didn't let others hold him back. He didn't let fear hold him back, and he always pushed himself to grow. Again, this is the type of man he was. I know in the past few days, I have heard him remind me of many of his famous sayings. And one was, "Don't dwell on the things you cannot change." I cannot change his passing and the tragic way he left and departed from this world. I can only change my attitude around this tragic loss and how I will choose to deal with it. I know that I will make Todd proud. I will face these coming months with the zest, grace, and enthusiasm that he did. And although I may not have the sense of humor that he did to get through these months, I have amazing friends, and I have amazing partners at work to get me through this, and I have my family. I also want to comfort many of you with the words my mom heard from him, and a still, quiet, calm voice, he whispered, Mom, I'm okay. And lastly, he shared with me in the hours I have been mourning that he was so thankful for all who had helped make his dreams come true. And he wants you to live your dreams full out. I'm sure this is just a portion of the man he was, as is it impossible for me to put into words who Todd was and what he meant to me and how he affected me and so many others. I'd like to end with a simple poem. My daughter, going into preschool, had to learn, and she rehearsed this in front of Uncle Todd many, many times. And I feel this describes him even more now what this means to me than before. It's not what you look like. It's not what you wear. It's not that you're rich. And it's definitely not your hair. It's how you treat people. It's how you live. It's how much you love and how much you give. Thank you.